What's going on, beautiful people of YouTube? This is Reem Bean, and welcome to episode 3 of Live Video Game Hunts, where I go to Goodwills, yard sales, flea markets, all that, and show you all the awesome stuff that I find throughout the week. And I gotta tell you, this week was absolutely amazing. Stick through to the end of the video, and we'll go over all the pickups, talk about them, and just show you all the cool stuff. This room is packed right now, just full of shit, and you'll see through some of these videos that we got some awesome finds. But as always, thank you so much for watching, and enjoy this video. All right, here we are with the first stop of the week, and it was a very awesome score. We're at Goodwill. I checked behind the glass, and I see some very good games in here. The first one that caught my eye was Wario's Smooth Moves, and you'll see there's about 5 games in here I pick up total, $1.50 each, and they are some really good titles in this one. All right, so I hunt down an employee to come over here and open up the cage for me. And when I start going through these games, I actually pull out a few more gems that I overlooked. The first one being here, Capcom versus Tatsunoko. I butchered the name, I'm sure, but for $1.50, that game's like $25-$30. Awesome score on it. Of course, I got Wario's Smooth Moves. That was the first one that I saw. Didn't get lucky in this. I was hoping there was like a Game Boy or a DS in that case, but there was jack shit, so I left it behind for someone else to go through. But I rarely get good finds in this cage. They don't update it as often as I had hoped, but I get better finds, you know, in the VHS section whenever they are in the DVD section. But I do pull out a few more good games. We got Lego Harry Potter, years 1 through 4, Lego Batman 2. Both $10, $15 games, but for $1.50, I'll pick those up all day long. I even find an original Xbox game that I did not have, which was the original trilogy here, Star Wars Lego 2. For whatever reason, I don't have any of the Lego's games for the original Xbox, so I definitely got to start collecting those again. We got Bioshock, the Ultimate Rapture Edition. Very cool 4-disc box here. I wanted to open up, make sure they're all there, but for $5, this thing was in excellent condition. You know I love my Bioshock series, so I definitely had to pick this up. So for all this, I don't know, I paid like $10, but very good steal, especially for that Capcom versus Tatsunoko game. But awesome start to the week. All right, so believe it or not, this is 3 to 4 hours after I got that awesome score for all the Wii games and whatnot. I'm on my lunch break, and I come across this, which was the Bouncer for PlayStation 2, an exclusive I did not have. I believe the publisher was Squaresoft, so it caught my eye. Very cool. Not everybody gets to go to Goodwill every day, but you know I work directly across from it, so I'm there every lunch break. I don't always get lucky, but the times that I do, it always makes the trip worth it. And for $1.50, that was just a cool little pickup 4 or 5 hours after I got that awesome score from earlier. But after this, I knew this week was going to be absolutely amazing, and it turns out this whole week was just excellent with pickups, as you'll see from the later stuff. So this guy posted an ad for a yard sale saying he was going to have some video game stuff, so I emailed him, asked him if I can come see the stuff early, and he let me. I was a little disappointed when I got there, though, because he said that he sold at, like, Comic-Con and things like that, so I knew all of his stuff was going to be individually priced, which it was, but I was lucky enough to catch his ass slipping a couple times here. I didn't pick up much, but I paid $20 for the 4 things that I got, and you'll see I did get some good things. I picked up Left 4 Dead, 2 Game Gears, both powered on, they both needed cap replacements, and I got the Lost World for Game Gear there, which is like a $15, $20 game, and he is like, I want $4 for it. But you can always get these people. Sometimes they don't know their stuff as well as they think they do, but not a bad pickup. Alright, so a pro tip, whenever you're in Goodwill hunting around, check the electronics section with the remotes and all that, VCRs. You'll find controllers and all sorts of stuff hid back there. Next to this Rock Band stuff, I picked up this Game Gear, which was super awesome for $1. Missing the backs, but I got plenty of those. Had a copy of Sonic 2 the Hedgehog. You find that game no matter where you are. You could be in the Himalayas camping out with fucking Bigfoot himself, and you come across a backpack with a Game Gear. Guaranteed the game inside of it's going to be Sonic 2. Picked it up with that Multi 201 or whatever it is console that you see. Those are older. They got that calculator. I remember those from way back. Picked them both up for $1. Very happy about that score. Anytime I pick up a Game Gear for under $5, whether it's broke or not, I'm always happy for because I refurbish them and I can sell them for a lot more. All right, so this is the first yard sale. This is a Friday. We didn't plan on yard selling, but I'm glad we did because we got some very awesome scores here, you'll see. The first stop here, I picked up my PlayStation 2 controller. Like I say, always get those. They wanted $1 or 2. Very happy to pay it. It's worth the risk to me. because those controllers are selling for $15 to $20, and I always need them to bundle up with systems because it's hard to sell a system without a controller, especially if it's aftermarket. So I picked that up for $2, and of course I'm going to ask them, hey, do you got any games? And of course they said they do, and they're going to hunt for me. So the guy hunts for me, and he actually pulls out like four or five common 360 games. He only wanted 50 cents a piece for them. I bought them all. Anytime you come across 360 games, they're under a dollar and they're not sports. Pick them up. They're great bundlers. And there may have even been one in there that I did not have. I can't remember from looking at the video, but awesome scores. That and a PS2 controller, I think I paid like $3 or $4. Awesome start for yard sales. So we stop at the flea market on a Friday. Like I said, we went out yard selling, and then we were on this side of town. We stop at the flea market, and I'm kind of glad I did. This guy right here, we deal with all the time. He buys storage units, and he will come across game stuff every so often, and he sells pretty cheap. He knows that I collect, and I also resell. So he joke with these people, be friendly with them, get on their level. Me and him, we joke all the time. I don't know his name. Fuck, I'm terrible with names, but we're friendly to each other. He hooks me up with good deals, and I come across this controller a lot, and you know I'm always preaching about my controllers. Pick them up when you can. Aftermarkets I try to avoid, but he had an N64 controller, a couple original Xbox controllers, a terrible knot right here, but luckily I'm married to a woman who can de-knot just about any situation. Plus, I have no patience for it for myself, so it's kind of a good backup. But anyways, for all this right here, also, I got a Wii Motion Plus controller. I paid $8 for all this. You know the Wii Motion Plus controller I can sell for like $15 anyways. Pay for all that, plus I have some controllers extra to bundle with other systems, which was good because I ended up coming across more original Xboxes down the road. 64 controller, the joystick was pretty beat up, but I want to do that mod where you can take the GameCube joystick. They sell this, it's like this aftermarket joystick, but it's modeled after the GameCube's joystick, and put it into an N64 controller. It's just one thing I haven't done. I'd like to do it. They say it doesn't work as well, it's just not as responsive as the standard joystick, but it'd just be cool to have, something I wanted to do. So I picked it up, but for $8, you can't argue all that. It gives my wife something to do with all those knots, so she definitely loves doing that sort of thing. The original Xbox controllers, the only downside of those is it did not have the dongle on the ends, but they're not expensive. If you don't know, original Xboxes have those breakaway dongles that go into the system, so if you tripped over the cord, it'll actually not pull the system or rip the cord, it'll just break away right there. But they didn't have them on the ends, but still, for $8 for all that, I can't argue it. I always check with this guy, he usually has something, we always joke around and we come across some good stuff every so often, and he's funny to deal with. You'll see later on for Saturday and Sunday pickups, I actually deal with him again. Look at my wife's disgust as she sees the knot she's about to handle. But it's good for her. It gives her something to do. Keeps her out of the bars. But anyways, you'll see the next sales, they just keep getting better and better from there. So I'm real happy about all this. So this is when the show gets juicy, people. This is an estate sale that we went to on a Friday. I was hunting for some games, and I almost missed these. And I'm so glad my peripherals are as good as they are. I see, you know, that little bit of GameCube game sticking out the side, and bam, there we go. We got Super Smash Brothers, Zelda, the Kmart edition, and then we got the Master Quest, the promo disc, which I did not have. I was super happy to find this. There was only three GameCube games here, and they were all good GameCube games. I was expecting to find like a 1080 or just something crappy, but they were all three awesome, and it made my day right there. That was an excellent, excellent find. It was so sweet. The little girl comes up to me. She says she wants $1 apiece for them. Me being the sheckler that I am, I did not have it in me to pay just $1 apiece. So I gave her $5, and you know, look at her. She's so sweet. It made her day, and I mean, don't shekel these people as hard as you need to. Sometimes pay what they want. If not, be a little bit generous, but $5 for those three games, awesome steal, man. Very happy. So this was my only find on Saturday at the flea market, but it happened to be a good find. This little dude here was selling some cartridge stuff, which was surprising. This stuff, I mean, is probably twice his age, and he was pulling out some cool titles here. I ended up getting this GameCube controller and this stack of Sega Genesis games. He said how much. He didn't know a price, so I said $20, he said $25, and the little bastard started haggling me, which was awesome. So, I mean, it makes me laugh, and we had fun, but I picked up Paperboy, 2 Sonic the Hedgehogs 2, Sonic Spinball, a copy of Fantasia, which I was very happy to get because that's one that I wanted for the Sega Genesis. Not crazy high-end, but just one that I wanted. I picked up a couple PS3 games. But for all that, I paid $23. My only find for the flea market, I'm happy I found something, but I'm happy it was a good something, too. That's how some of these videos will go. Sometimes it'll just be all yard sales. It might be all flea market sales. Who knows? This week, it was all about the yard sales and Goodwill, so we had some very good scores from that. But happy to pick this up after this is when we just started yard selling like crazy, and we just kept finding awesome scores. But this little dude was awesome. You can see he's smiling. I'm sure he was happy to make him some extra money selling his damn great-granddad shit. For all I know, the little bastard was young as hell. But you never know who's going to be selling this stuff, whether it's an old person or a little young kid. But anyways, $23 for that. Very happy. Sega Genesis and some PS3 games. Good score, plus the GameCube controller. Always get them controllers. So this was my first solo yard sale. My wife goes her own route and I go my own route. And the first sale that I go to on Saturday morning, of course they got some games after I ask them. And I always love seeing that sight when they're walking out of that house from searching and they come with some games. She didn't have nothing crazy special here, but I did pick up a few titles. They were dirt cheap. I don't know if they were like $2, $3 a piece. I can't remember. But they were super dirt cheap and they were just some good common titles. Always do that. People, don't be scared to go to a yard sale or at the flea market. Don't be scared to say, hey, do you got any video games or do you happen to have anything? They're going to tell you two answers, yes or no, and one of those answers is going to lead to something like this. I mean, no matter where you go, yeah, I picked up Vice City for original Xbox just because I'm, like I said, coming across these original Xboxes a lot, and it's a good bundler. Makes the system sell a little bit better. I picked up, I think, Halo Reach and called it. I cannot remember the price that she wanted for these games, but for common titles, I don't pay more than a couple bucks a piece for. But I did pick them up. Very happy. It's just when you go to the first sale on that day and you find something, it just sets the mood for the whole day. And I happened to find something, so it got my juices pumping and got me ready to go. So as you'll see, we find nothing but more stuff. Every cell I hit, for the most part, had some games. Of course, I had stopped at plenty that didn't, but we had a really good week this week, you'll see. So this was my second or third stop, and this was by far one of my favorite pickups. I was very happy about this one. I asked this lady, hey, do you got any old games? She says, well, I got some vintage stuff, and you know what? I happen to love vintage games. And so I go over here, and she pulls this lid off, and right away I see the NES Power Pad. I knew she unearthed that thing, and it was just amazing. We got two consoles. I picked up the NES Power Glove. There was a handful of games. There was even a few SNES games, Donkey Kong 1 and 3. For this whole bucket here, including the tote, because I didn't want to damn bag this up. I was like, you going to throw this tote in? $20, man. There was a complete in-box Duck Hunt, which isn't as common as you think, so that was cool to have. I'll put that with my box stuff. I didn't try to haggle or shekel her down. $20 is a great deal for all that with the power pad. I even got an awesome lid for that tote, and I can always use more totes. But that right there, man, I knew that this was just going to be an awesome day, and it just kept getting better. So very cool, very happy pickup. She was awesome. $20 for that big old bucket of stuff. You'll see in the pickups video exactly what I got from it, but very happy about it. Just a good score altogether. You can't argue things like that. So this isn't the sexiest pickup that I had, but it was one that I'm happy about. I saw these original Xbox controllers, but what was weird about them is they were wireless controllers. But the dongle worked for both controllers. It was weird. Like I always say, I'll say in every video I have, pick up those controllers if you can. I rarely pick up aftermarkets, but I did pick these up. I cycled through the games and I saw they had Halo 2, which is an excellent bundler game. It's just some old folks, so obviously they're going to sell this stuff dirt cheap. Picked up, there was one original Xbox controller, and the other two were aftermarket. But they were weird because they had that one dongle you can see, and it worked for both. I'll bundle that with one system, or I might keep them, I don't know. I like keeping weird controllers like that. But for all this, I think I paid $5 for all controllers plus Halo 2. Not a bad deal. I just like to keep that momentum going when I'm finding these games. I don't like to, you know, go between like 10 sales and not find nothing. You want to keep that momentum burning and going, keep those juices going, because you're going to have nothing but good luck. And I'm glad I did, because we just kept finding stuff and kept finding stuff. Man, I was so happy. But picked that up, $5. Good little buy. I'm happy about it. So at this yard sale, this guy was super awesome. He was funny. He was cool to talk to. They had some games stacked out here. Some pretty cool Wii titles. I didn't know the prices right off the gate. I wanted to look for them before I even offered him a price or discussed it. But the whole time, you know, always talk to these people. Be friendly and courteous. Get them, because I'm telling you, if they're happy with you, they're going to work with you. And, of course, I ended up getting a bunch of stuff from this guy. Look at that belt buckle, that Bullet Bill belt buckle next to it. That was really cool. I picked it up for $1. There was a few Game Boy games. I picked those up. It was like Paperboy and Rampage and SimCity. All games were $1 a piece. He's looking at that cardboard to try to remember the prices they wanted for him. So, of course, I picked up like Ratchet and Clank, the Wii games. I left a few behind, but I picked up a lot of good titles from this guy. And for whatever reason, this whole day, you can see there's an original Xbox right there. It was an original Xbox type of day. And usually I might find one every other week, but today I found a couple, as well as the controllers and whatnot. So I ended up picking it. Like, I left this yard sale $23 lighter, and you'll see that I pick up these stack of games. That original Xbox, I'm bundling everything together, because, you know, he's like, how much do you want to pay for that original Xbox? And I said, well, let's just stack everything together and see what we're going to go from, you know, do from there. I picked up that belt buckle. I picked up both Game Boy Advance games, probably like 6 games from them. And you'll see that there's also 2 strategy guides as well. And I typically don't get strategy guides, but I did pick these 2 up. But for those games and the original Xbox controllers and cords, it was just $20. So that was a good deal by itself. It was only until later when I turned around and I saw those guides on the ground that I picked up for, he said, 4 a piece. I was like, well, do both for 3, and he did. So here's the 2 strategy guides that I pick up. I get Golden Sun as well as the Street Fighter one. I don't typically pick up strategy guides, but these were ultra cheap. The Golden Sun caught my eye, so paid $3 for both of those. He wanted 2 a piece, but always being the Sheckler I am, want to get a little bit lower price. Then he go over here to the original Xbox, and all the cords were tangled up. I didn't have my detangler with me, so I had to do it myself, but they're got all the cords that I needed. It was complete. Had the controllers and both TV as well as the power cord. And the original, it was the Halo Edition controller. So very cool. Pick those up. Happy about all that. So $23 from this sale. Not too bad at all. Here's another cool sale where I got more than I thought I was actually going to get or was supposed to get. Always ask any games. They said no, but I've searched anyways, and I found a box that had a PlayStation 2, 2 official controllers, and a few crappy games. The sticker on this VCR said $20. I didn't know if that was for the whole box or what, but I pull out the PlayStation. Very nice condition. The Slims always sell good. I can usually get $60-$70 on, depending on what's with it. I ask her how much you want for this PlayStation. She says $20, but the price is negotiable. Whenever people say that, I mean, my shekel meter goes through the roof, because I'm going to lowball the shit out of them because they are not confident with themselves. Of course, I'm going to be nice about it, and I think I rebutted. You know, I'm sitting here holding on to it, you know, and then I was like, how about $10? And she says, how about $15? So we settled on $12 for all this. I don't like to pay that much for PlayStation 2s if I don't have to. I try to keep it under. What really caught my eye was the controllers. You know how I am about my controllers. They were official. So that the PlayStation was more of a plus, but it had the adapter, TV cord, all that. It'll be complete. A few crappy games. But for $12 for this, I was very happy. But it turns out the VCR was with it, and it was a VCR-DVD combo. And I need a new VCR for the game room, and I'm thinking about putting this one in there. So, and that's what I run my Atari through. So it was a nice VCR, but for $12 for this whole box of stuff, that was a super deal on that. I'm very happy about that. But that was just one of those sales where I got more than I thought I was going to get, because I tried to walk away with just the PlayStation. She's like, oh, no, the VCR comes with it. I was like, sweet, I'll take that too. Here's a side-of-the-road freestyle sale that I stopped at. It was huge, and I got some really cool scores in this one. This lady actually, these games were hidden away. I was like, you mind if I take a look in this box? And I pulled out some titles that I did not have, and they were awesome priced. I got GTA 4, which I do not have, surprisingly enough. So I picked it up, as well as Dead Rising and that very cool Halo edition, or Halo 5. I think that was like the limited edition box you got with it. But picked 2 games up, as well as that box, for $5. Cool little pickup right away. I had Dead Rising 2. It was Dead Rising, the original one. For whatever reason, I did not have it as well. So I picked those up. Always happy to get games I do not have for a great price. So $5 for those three. Very cool. Can't argue that. Some of my best finds are at Freestyle Stop. So this is what that was. And you'll see I got one more find here at this stop. But it never hurts to go to these Freestyles. Never miss a sale if you can help it. Here's the second part of that Freestyle sale, and I asked this lady if she had any games. She pulls out one, but for a buck, I got this game away here for the DS. Cool little find for a dollar, and I was able to go on my merry way to the other sales. Here's another example of asking someone if they got games, them going in the house and pulling out said games. I got some really cool Wii titles here. I got Resident Evil, Trauma Center game, Trauma Team, which turned out to be sealed, Super Punch-Out. Maybe another one, but I paid $10 for this. I tried to shekel him down. I was like, hey, man, you take $8. He's like, I know what these games are worth. And the dick in me wanted to say, if you did, you'd be charging more, but I didn't. I always be nice and courteous. But $10 for this stack, very happy. Good little Wii pickup. This was another Freestyle as well, so good stop, very happy. So a lot of my pickups this week came from Freestyle Yard Sales. This was just another one here. I almost passed it up, but I did see the outline of a 360 game when I was pulling up, so I stopped, and she's shuffling through, and this broke my heart to see this. This was Rage for the 360, just scattered around. That was actually a very fun game. I don't know if a lot of you people liked it. I did. Very short, but awesome game. I'm giving her time to set things up, and in this box over here, I saw a few more games. The games here that I picked up were not spectacular, but they were cheap. They were a dollar a piece. So anytime, like I say, you come across a 360 PS3 game, something like that, and it's not sports and it's a dollar, pick it up. One of the games I got was sealed. It was nothing special. It was a Kinect game, some dance game or something. I don't know, fitness game. It was a dollar. I picked up three games or so. Turning Point, which turned out to be my second copy this week I picked up. So I paid like $3 or so. Picked up, those were the Kinect games that I got. Anytime you see those purple disc games or purple case games, they're always going to be Kinect games. But one was sealed, so I picked it up. Very happy. Like I said, I'm just keeping that momentum going. I'm keeping my flow going. I'm wanting to find pickups at every stop. But this lady was cool. We're chatting. Of course, I'm asking her if she's got any older retro stuff, and she didn't. You see that I left Dishonored there, but you'll see that I walk away. I get that change of heart feeling, and I turn around, and I pick that thing right back up. But for a dollar, I mean, come on, pick these games up. It ain't going to hurt you at all. They're great bundlers, and they're good trade bait for later on with friends, or if you're reselling, it doesn't matter. But this lady was cool. They were definitely some stoners. That's what we were talking about for the most part. But you'll see me turn around and then turn right back around, and I get that change of heart, and I'm like, oh, I need that Dishonored. It's a buck. Why not? But good little stop, good Freestyle. So this is an awesome example of, do you have any video games that you're selling and where it pays off tremendous? I asked this kid, I was like, hey man, you got any games? He pulls out some stuff from his collection as well as, I guess, some of his father's stuff, because this stuff was way before his time with the cartridge stuff. He pulls out Super Smash, Super Mario Brothers, and Banjo-Tooie. I didn't have Banjo-Tooie. I'm very happy to pick that up, as well as the other games. But for those six games there, I paid $20. I'm not going to try to beat this kid down, haggle him any more than that, because you know what this stuff's worth. Very good deal on that. The kid was awesome to bring the stuff out, so I could not, you know, argue at all. Republic Commando for the original Xbox, that's like a $15 game, and you know the pricing of the other stuff. So very cool pickup, awesome Freestyle on this one. I'm just keeping that momentum going, keeping the flow moving, and I'm getting these pickups, man. Like I said, this week has just been awesome for this stuff. So been finding stuff all week, and today was no exception. So this is the first sale on Sunday. I'm at the flea market. Didn't plan on stopping, but I'm glad I did. There were some really cool scores that I got. I asked this person, I was like, hey man, you got any games? And he pulls out some stacks here. He had PS3 titles as well as a couple controllers over there, but we'll get those here in a minute. And you'll see I got Tekken. I got the Sonic Sega Genesis collection right there, leaving the sports. I did not pick up the Call of Duties, I don't believe. One of my other buddies did later on, but I did pick up like three games from him, and we originally talked about these controllers, and I bundled all this together, and he said, I want $30 for it. And that kind of broke my heart a little bit. So I moved the controllers off to the side, and he wanted just $5 for like three games. And then we talked about these controllers a little bit later on, and I ended up paying $15 just for the two controllers, which was a good deal. So $20 for what he originally wanted for 30, so not too bad. You'll see that there's also this blue Wii Nunchuck over here. I got the original Motion Plus controller, and this will go great with it. It's the same color, same. It was for it. So for $2, and then that right there was a good first pickup of the flea market for Sunday. So very happy about that. Sometimes you just kind of work around these deals. Don't be scared to set something back and rework it, but very happy with that. Good pickup for Sunday. So this lady vends at the flea market all the time, and she is super sweet and super kind, and she always does awesome deals. And I asked her if she had any games before she started setting up, and she pulls out two. I did pick up the Call of Duty combo pack here. She's like, what do you want to pay for it? And I try not to shekel her too hard because she's so nice, but I paid two for that. She would have probably gave it to me for $1. She's always so nice, and I've gotten some really good scores from her. I always check her out when she stops at the flea market. She's very awesome. Very cool person to deal with. So a lot of what I picked up on Sunday this morning was just mainly stuff for me, stuff that I didn't have. There was a lot of 360 titles out, and of course I collect for the 360. And here I picked up Dark Souls, and what else did I pick up here? Let me see. I got Dark Souls and Two Worlds. I think they wanted like five each, but I think I paid seven for both, which was a good deal. I was happy about that. Anytime I pick up something I don't have, it's always cool. And these were some good titles. One of these days, I was actually thinking about getting into Dark Souls. I hear it's brutal. I don't know if I'm ready to put myself through such punishment, but I did pick that up. Awesome little score right there. Sunday, it was very casual for me Sunday. I wasn't really hunting as hard as I felt like I should because I had such an amazing week. But happy to pick this up. $7, good little deal. So this is that same vendor you seen from earlier. This is that guy who buys storage units and comes across games. And he had a stack here. He actually picked these up from another table like that I missed out on. But he's still going to give me good deals. I checked his Left 4 Dead. And unfortunately, the Left 4 Dead was in terrible condition. It had a crack. And I told him about that. Like, I'm being friendly. I was like, man, make sure you check these games. Look at them before you buy them. Especially the titles that are going to make the price worth it. And this one was in terrible condition. I showed him that rings cracked, but he was cool about it, and I was able to pick up a few titles here that I did not have. It was Need for Speed and something else, but for this right, he I think he originally was like five a piece, and I think I paid like six for two because he's cool like that. Like I said, I'd get him laughing, get him joking, but I picked up Need for Speed, and what else did I pick up? Oh, and Heroes right there for the Xbox 360. Always trying to grow that 360 collection. I'm probably, 200 games in right now. Very awesome system to collect for. You know I'm a big Xbox fan. If it's any exclusive, it goes on PS2 or PlayStation 3. It's exclusive only, but 360, original Xbox, I'll get third party, whatever. I'll get it all. But this guy is awesome, man. Always be friendly with your vendors. Get to know them because they'll cut you awesome deals, and this guy does. I would have picked that Left 4 Dead up had it not been beat all to hell. There's no way I could fix that. I got a nice resurfacing machine, but it can't save cracks, so... Make sure you check your disc, and I tell him, I was like, if you're not going to check the disc, at least make sure that the disc is in there, because it's not so much that people are trying to shit you by not giving you the games, they don't realize the disc is even in there, or if it's missing, so always be friendly, give advice, and don't be a dick. This guy is awesome, so definitely worth the stop every time I see him. Here's a quick little pickup that I was happy about. For $2, I got Ridge Racer 5 here. I'm not 100% if that was exclusive PlayStation 2, but at $2, it wasn't going to hurt me to pick it up at all. The lady was cool. I did try to shekel her down to $1, but she said they were her sons. I'm not going to argue or be a dick about it. I paid her $2. I was happy. She was happy. It was a casual Sunday. I'm just casually moving, very happy, enjoying my day off. So picked it up, $2, good stop. So here's the last pickup for the week. This was the last table I went to on the flea market today. And I saw Yoshi's Touch and Go, as well as SX Tricky, and then Star Wars eventually for the GameCube. Paid $5 for that. It was a very awesome deal. GameCube games, obviously are getting up there in price. Now, the ones that I picked up, weren't the craziest of all games. I was more eager or more excited about the Yoshi's Touch and Go. I did not have it for the DS. Hunting around, this guy just had stuff everywhere, and of course, you don't see it in the video later on, but I go through all this stuff. I didn't find anything else, because when I saw one GameCube game, I was just hoping there was going to be more. Below, you'll see I go through a big box. That's where I find the Star Wars right there. And good pickup there. $5 for all three games. Very happy about it. It was a good finisher for the week. Like, I was content with this. I was happy. I'm like, it's time to go home. Last $5 I need to spend. He had some cool PC games in here, but I really don't collect any PC games. I like the big box artwork for some games, but that's all I look for. Nothing too special down here. I actually had one hunter next to me who got there late on the draw, and he's trying to look through everything. I'm happy. I'm done. But the only cool thing I saw in this box of PC games was like Half-Life 2, but I didn't need it. I passed and moved on. But that's it for all my pickups of the week. So let's go over all the stuff here. All right, we're going to go real quickly over all these pickups. This is a metric fuck ton of shit to go over, and hopefully we're going to make it real quick so we're not making this video 5 hours long. I'm going to start zooming through it and show you all the pickups we got. No particular order. All right, we got the Halo Collector's Edition box, the Halo 5, the Steel 10. Paid $2, but I bundled all that, got that and a few games for $5. My wife picked up some things you won't see on camera. Picked up a DS with 3 games, including Bubble Bobble for the Game Boy Advance. $15 for that, really good deal. Move on, there's so much stuff we gotta go through. The Nerf, holy fuck, Nerf Instrike with the gun. Something I did not have, you know, I love my crappy Wii stuff. Let's see, God, there's no particular order for all this stuff. It's just madness for this whole video. Away for the DS, I paid $1 for that. Let's see, one of the bundles, we'll save that for later. We got Warhawk for the PS3. Like I said, there's no particular order. I can't exactly remember all the sales that I did with this stuff, how I picked it up, but we're just going to go over it. The bags here, I got this at a yard sale. I paid, I have no idea, maybe like $5. I got wireless Xbox, original Xbox controllers, which are pretty cool because I got some consoles I need to make with. One wired controller and a copy of Halo 2. So good bundlers. I think I paid $5 for that. Very good deal. What else we got? At one yard sale, I picked up an original Xbox as well with 2 controllers. The Halo Edition original Xbox controller, which is awesome to have. It's got a messed up joystick, but I can fix that by a swap out. At that same yard sale, I picked up 2 strategy guides. We got Street Fighter 4, and then we got Golden Sun. Very cool. I paid $3 for both of those. At that same sale, we also got, for $1 a piece, we got SimCity 2000 for the Game Boy Advance, Paperboy and Rampage, a combo cart, and also this really cool Bullet Bill belt buckle. I thought that was awesome. Let's see, let's just keep going over stuff. Here's another bag. This was the controller lot that I got from the flea market on Friday, I think. I paid $8 for. We got original Xbox. We got a Wii Motion Plus controller with the condom slipping off. Never let that condom slip off. Never good. N64 controller with a jack stick. But I got this because I want to get the GameCube joystick. They make that on eBay where you can put that in there instead. And I think that'd be cool to have. Some PS3 controller, PS2 controller, another original Xbox. $8 for that. Like I always say, get controllers. Controllers are going up in price. Let's see what else we got. Uh-oh, can't have that falling down. Alright, we're still new to this live video stuff. Alright, we got, there's so much stuff in this room. Everything's, the room is crowded. PS2 lot, picked up the console, a couple games, nothing, you know, crazy, but 2 very good, nice, very good condition controllers, and I paid $12 for that, and there was also a VCR included. Not bad deal on that, because those things will sell all day for $60. What else we got? Controllers. Alright, let's start going over all these individual games. I got this at a Goodwill. The Bioshock Collector's Ultimate Rapture Edition. Very cool. You know I love my Bioshock series. At the same Goodwill, we got some awesome games here. Harry Potter Years 1 through 4. These are all $1.50 a piece. They still got the sticker on the side. Very cool find. I'm going to butcher that. Tatsunoko versus Capcom. Batman 2, DC Super Heroes, WarioWare, Smooth Moves, $1.50, man, come on. Another, a separate day at Goodwill, I got The Bouncer for $1.50 for PS2. It was a game I did not have. Nothing crazy expensive, but just an exclusive I didn't have.
Goodwill as well. We got Star Wars 2, the original trilogy, which I did not have for the original Xbox, and that's very cool when I can find anything. We got a bunch of 360 games here to go through. Always pick up Left 4 Dead. If you can get it under $5, get it, because the games, it constantly stays like somewhere between like $15 or so. Left 4 Dead, Call of Duty Modern Warfare 3, Tom Clancy's End War, Skyrim, Battlefield 3, and a game I don't have, which is Turning Point, Fall of Liberty. Let's see here. We got just so much shit, man. God of War. So much stuff, I'm not even remembering exactly where I got all this stuff. I have to rewatch the video. I got this because if it says only on PlayStation, I'm going to buy it even if it's sports. I've paid cheap. If it's sports, I'm going to pay cheap as shit. Rainbow Six Vegas. Resident Evil, The Umbrella Chronicles. Metroid Prime 3 Corruption. Alright, here we go. These were a buck a piece. I remember this. Ratchet and Clank. Ratchet and Clank Going Commando. These were not. These were at a separate sale. House of the Dead Overkill, which is not the original case, but that's fine. Trauma Center, second option or opinion. Resident Evil, the Wii Edition. Very cool, man. I ain't got no problem with that. A sealed Trauma Team, nothing special, but still about $20 or so. It's cool to find sealed anything. Trauma Team is one I didn't have, so I'll just keep it sealed. Dishonored, I paid $1 for it. Some of these crappy 360 games I did pay $1 for, like Dance Central, you know, I'm going to be boogieing the hell out of that one. Grand Theft Auto Vice City. Another copy of Turning Point, Fall of Liberty. Call of Duty 2. A sealed, super expensive Dance Paradise here, that's going to be hot. Dead Rising, I picked this up because I don't think I have it. I got 2 and 3, 3 for Xbox, but I don't believe I have that one for 360. Another copy of Modern Warfare 2, I did not have. I know I should have had it in my collection, but I guess I got rid of it at one point. Grand Theft Auto 4, I need to give this game another chance. I played it, and I get like halfway through it, and you can only hear, "Would you like to go bowling?" You know, how many times do you want to hear that before you stop playing? So I don't need to give another shot. Punch-Out. No original case, picked that up, that was another lot. At the flea market, I got some very cool deals here. This one kid was selling a stack of games. I got all this here for $23, a little shit haggled me, which I love, man, that's cool. GameCube controller in pretty decent condition. Joystick's a little whoppy, just looks weird, but works. We got Frogger, Helmet Chaos, don't come apart. Star Wars 3, Star Wars Force Unleashed, and then he had some cartridge stuff. Little bastard was young as hell, and he had this cartridge stuff. We got Uncommon Paperboy for the Sega Genesis. Very cool to have that. Goofy's Historical Tour. I got two copies of Sonic 2 the Hedgehog. Good bundlers whenever you're selling the system. Another one to bundle with it, Sonic Spinball. And one that I needed that I was happy to get. Fantasia. Cool find on that flea market day. One of the yard sales on a Friday, I think it was, or something like that. I think I saw this guy early. Two Game Gears, both broke, but I paid like $5 a piece for it, and $4 for the Lost World. He thought he was shekeling, but he don't realize that's like a $15-$20 game. Got his ass, and I can fix the Game Gear, so I'm pretty happy about that. Let's get into this cool shit here before we get into Sunday shit. So went up on that lady, asked her if she had any retro stuff. She's like, "I got some vintage games." Well, I happen to love vintage stuff, so she pulls out this tote that it wasn't filled to the brim, but there was some really good shit in there. I'll show you what we got. We got the Zapper. We got the awesome Power Glove. We got some carts here. We got Donkey Kong 3, Donkey Kong Country. A little dirty, but my wife loves to clean things for me. We got Super Mario Brothers, the trilogy here of Super Mario Brothers, Track Meet and Duck Hunt. A very fun game, Little Nemo, Little Nemo Dream Master. Very fun game, actually. Big Bird's Hide and Speak, and complete in box, very cool, actually, was Duck Hunt. This is not as common as you think, so I want to keep that. It smells super moldy, but that's that old smell. You got to love it. A lot of you collectors out there know what I'm talking about. When it smells old, you know it's old. And then there was two consoles. One's a little yellowed. There were three controllers and all the hookups. I don't need to show you all that shit. You know what they look like. And for whatever reason, I did not have this, but now I do, which is the amazing power pad. So all that I paid $20 for. You can't argue that shit. Went to an estate sale. Came across looking for some games. I almost missed these, and I'm glad I caught them out of the corner of my eye. And they were some GameCube games. And the only GameCube games they had happened to all be awesome heavy hitters. So we got the Kmart exclusive Wind Waker. One that I did not have, which pissed me off that I didn't, but now I do, which was the bonus disc of, I think you got this when you pre-ordered, but you got Master Quest in there, awesome, and of course, you can never forget Smash. The little girl asked for $1 a piece, I'm not a dick, I gave her $5 and I went on my way. That was cool, so that was all for that, and then today, this morning, this is Sunday's find. Some of this stuff I didn't film, just because it's reseller shit. I got some buddies that sell, and you don't need to see me hunting a reseller's table, because that's stupid. That's not me hunting. That would be like watching someone fish in a barrel. You don't need to see that. There's no hunting. I got good deals, but it's not hunting to me. This was hunting, and I did get this on camera. Guy had some, I saw Yoshi's Touch and Go, and then I looked around and saw SS Tricky, and then Star Wars Rebel Strike. Got all that for $5. I ain't gonna argue that. That was a good deal. Let's see here. Another hunt you would have saw. We got Tekken. No, don't be bouncing around in there. Holy fuck. Alright. Need for Speed Most Wanted. Sonic's Ultimate Genesis Collection. The combo pack of Call of Duty 1 and 2. For Black Ops. Paid $2 for that. We also got the camo PlayStation 3 controller as well as the normal. And then we got the official blue nunchuck, and I got the Wii Motion Plus blue controller, so that'll match it now. I didn't pay too much for that. So let's see, we picked up Ridge Racer 5 for PS2. I picked this up for $1. I thought this was cool. This is like a Pops, but it's a Qbert machine. I thought that was super cute. I picked this up for $1. That'll look cool if I can find a spot for it, which will be very hard to do, I'm sure. Two Worlds and Dark Souls. I can't remember what I paid. Maybe $7 or something like that for that. Games I didn't have. Here's two more I did not have, which was Heroes Over Europe and Need for Speed Pro Street. And then what I got from the reseller here, which is what I did not film. I paid $20 for all this. We got Weapon Lord for Super Nintendo. I got World Heroes. And I got Never Dead. Three games I did not have. I really think that's it. I hope it's it. God damn, that's a lot of fucking shit. Awesome week. I really hope you guys enjoyed this video. This was an excellent week. Who knows? Not all weeks are going to be good. I'm sure I might have a 10-15 minute long video. But I'm only going to try to show you nothing but hunts. You don't want to see me going out there looking at a reseller's table. Going in Goodwill, just looking around, not finding shit. That'd be like watching the Hunting Network and watching the guy shoot at a turkey but never getting one. Watching the Fishing Channel, watching them throw a line but never pulling a fish. That's pointless. I hope you guys enjoyed this video, and thank you so much for watching. And as always, take care.